Today I'm going to talk a little bit about using a slider. A slider is a cheap and easy way to replace a dolly for shots in which you'd like camera movement. Now, although this is 4 feet long, it is still pretty cost effective. I think we ended up spending only about $150, and you can find it at any of your favorite online video retailers. It is pretty slick, and I'd like to share with you some of the thoughts that I have and some of the impressions that it put upon me. For starters, if you're going to get a long slider, and in this case, like I said, we went with one that's about 4 feet long, you need to understand that you probably need at least one extra tripod. Or at the edge of each of the nodes of the slider are mounts to put a tripod. And while you can put a tripod simply in the middle, if you're going to be doing movement that is a lot one direction or the other, it's going to be quite a bit more simple to just have the ends of the slider mounted and stable. Now, it does have feet that you can use on a table or a floor or any sort of flat or even potentially uneven surface, because it does have adjustable feet to level things out, and built into the middle of the slider plate is a level or balance, and so you can get a sense of how even the slider is. The heavier the camera, the more difficult it is to get started and to get it stopped, because it tends to have inertia. When you push it, it sort of jumps for a second, and when you stop, it just sort of dies. And so when you're moving the camera along the slider, one of the things to be thinking about is, at the beginning of the shot, do I want there to be movement or not? Because if you want the shot to be stable and then begin to use the slider, you need to understand it might be a little tricky because it might kind of jump or lurch. And one of the things that if you go online and do some digging that they're going to suggest is that you use some sort of a tripod head so that you can adjust the camera's movement or pan or tilt, and I think that's a really good idea. I'm simply not showing it with the one that we used. The problem with it is that as the camera goes higher, it becomes even less stable. And so when you're going to use a slider, particularly this slider, I strongly suggest that you assume that when you cut to the shot, you already are going to be seeing the movement in the frame, and that the movement in the frame is going to continue through to the end of the shot, as opposed to the slider stopping or slowing. Like I said, you almost certainly need a tripod head. The camera mounts directly onto the slider head, and that's just not very handy. In this case, what I've done is I've put a quick release plate, and if you look at the Manfrotto quick release plate video that I have, this is the exact same configuration where I can pop that little puppy off and get the camera off. But when we use it on our production that we shot this summer, we ended up using a tripod head, and it was pretty handy because then we weren't sort of subject to the plane of the slider to determine what the shots are. Along with this idea of there being inertia, keep in mind that the heavier the camera, the more work that you have to do to get it to start moving and to keep it moving. And so think about the amount of time that you want to spend getting your shot set up. We use it for only a couple shots, and we are generally pretty quick shooters, and to get the ends of the tripod or the ends of the slider stabilized with two tripods, to get the head mounted on the slider plate, to get the camera mounted on the tripod and the tripod head, and then to rehearse and practice the movement took a considerable amount of time. We didn't under budget the time because I was assuming it was going to take a while, but be smart about that and keep in mind that it might slow down the shoot if you don't have two other tripods handy already mounted to the slider and ready to be used in action. Again, this is the 4 foot slider from Glide Gear. It's well worth the money. It is going to give you an opportunity to practice working with a slider without having to go and throw down boku bucks to get something really fancy. You'll get a sense of, do I really want this? Am I better off going with a dolly, or is the slider going to be cutting it for what I want? You're going to get some good experience with it, and I think you're going to get your money's worth out of it. Thanks for watching.